Kane fingertips away from the bottom rope.
What the hell?
AJ rang the bell, but the referee's explaining to her that Kane didn't tap. AJ a bit over anxious here at ringside.
Oh, and Daniel Bryan gets the news that Kane did not tap out to the Yes Lock.
Oh!
Ring rattling choke slam.
That's it, baby.
Kane pins Bryan.
Here is your winner, Kane.
Well, it appeared that AJ accidentally hit the bell. And it was pretty clear that Kane never tapped out.
Right, but I don't know if it was an accident or not that AJ rang the bell when Kane was locked in the Yes Lock.
Yeah, I don't know what the hell is going through AJ's mind, man. I mean, she is totally... Look at this. I mean, she just skipping off like nothing happened.
The bottom line is Kane wins the match. Kane has defeated Daniel Bryan here tonight. I don't think it's a coincidence that AJ was around. Nonetheless, Dolph Ziggler knocked off Jack Swagger Monday on Raw, proving to Vicky he's worthy of her respect and affection. So tonight, Dolph Ziggler looks to take the next step and knock off the world champion Sheamus. It's Sheamus and Ziggler tonight on SmackDown.
And there is the interim general manager of Raw on SmackDown this week. The hardcore legend Mick Foley appears to be on his way to the ring. Is Mick going to address the WWE Universe next?
I hope he took a bath.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mick Foley.
Well, with Mr. Laurinaitis fired as general manager of both Raw and SmackDown, the WWE Board of Directors will be appointing Gasker interim GMs of both shows. Great start with the legendary Mick Foley.
And we learned earlier on tonight that Vicky Guerrero is going to be in charge of things next week. But what do you think Mick's got planned here tonight? I'm glad he dressed up for the occasion. The tie-dye and the jacket go
Mick's
good together.
He's looking real good. I mean, he's got a great ensemble. I mean, he's got those Bruno Bagley shoes on.
Booker,
looking good.
He's wearing sneakers.
Those are not Bruno Bagley.
All right. Thank you for the very nice response. Thank you to John Laurinaitis for being so lame as SmackDown general manager that he's been fired. Giving me one night to come back and have some great fun right here in Baltimore, Maryland.
You told me following Monday Night Raw that Heath Slater is, and I quote, your favorite WWE superstar.
You know why? Because he's a loser just like you.
He's a one man.
That's why.
Rock band. And he put Cyndi Lauper and he put Wendi Richter and he put Roddy Piper in their place. And everybody in the WWE Universe owes this man a tremendous amount of credit for shutting those old fools up.
I come out here to lead a little protest, okay? Last Monday, Cyndi Lauper, Roddy Piper, they embarrassed me. Mick, you better do something about it.
First of all, Heath, you're being way too tough on yourself. Cyndi Lauper is a very formidable competitor, nothing to be embarrassed about. But tonight, your opponent tonight may give you something to be embarrassed about, because your opponent tonight is...
Woo, woo, woo!
Oh, no.
You know it!
Oh, the goof-o-meter just went through the roof.
Well, Mick Foley's in charge tonight. Mick Foley from Long Island, giving another Long Islander an opportunity on Friday Night SmackDown.
Listen to the tag pack, baby. Listen to him.
Great job, Mick. Glad you're back.
Hell of a job.
So Heath Slater against Zack Ryder. I heard a rumor that Zack Ryder tanned not once, but twice today. Hence the reason that he looks like Well, he's very bronze.
I like this kid. I mean, Zack Ryder.